I'm Tyler DeLarkey, and this is Noah Robinson. We're of the class of 2019, and we've been doing some fun stuff in the field of STEM this year, thanks to the Bangor High School STEM program. So why don't you tell them about ISEF?
So next week, or the week after next week, Ty and I will be attending ISEF, which is the International Science and Engineering Fair. So what we basically did over the course of the last year, we've had these extended research projects, and we've put these together with the help of various different mentors at UMaine and on the home front, as well as aid from our classmates, and put together projects that we presented at the Maine State Science Fair. The top three people from the Maine State Science Fair get to attend the International Science Fair, and Ty and I took first and second place, so we will be attending.
So for my project, what I did is I built a tactile display for the blind. So this is a wearable vest, which will allow someone who's blind or visually impaired to actually navigate in a safe, intuitive, and cost-effective way. So this basically functions where depth data from a depth sensing camera can actually be presented through a system of tactile motors, which vibrate to signify how close things are. And so that was my project. Noah actually had a psychology project, which had both really interesting methods and a really cool impact. So.
Yeah, so I studied a political aspect really with my psychology. So I looked at how the effect of a voting building can affect someone's likelihood to vote for one candidate over another through this psychological idea of priming, which is this idea that different external factors and different stimuli can make you behave and act in slightly different ways. So I basically looked at how people were more likely to vote for a Republican candidate if they were voting in a church. And that's what I studied, and that's what I found was the case.
Yeah, and fortunately, we're trying to be really proactive in terms of searching out different research opportunities. So in terms of also our partnership with UMaine in terms of getting research mentors and positions as internships and different opportunities to get into different colleges and things like that. We're also invested into loads of different actual science fair competitions. And another one that we look at is actually the Junior Science and Humanities Symposium, which is sponsored by the Department of Defense. And luckily this year, of the five papers, research papers that get selected for the Northern New England region, we had three of the papers that got selected this year, Connor Nodden, Spencer Campbell, and myself. And we took first place, second place, and third place at the regional fair this year, meaning that all of us get to go actually to the National Junior Science and Humanities Symposium, which is in Hunt Valley, Maryland next week. And we'll be going there and showing off sort of the Bangor pride, Bangor spirit, and really trying to do well and presenting our research and trying to do well there.
We also stretch beyond just pure research in the STEM field, right? So recently we just had a science bowl competition. Last month we had a statewide science bowl competition, which is a sort of quiz bowl Jeopardy style competition where you have five team members, four competing at once, and a reader will read out science questions that get harder as the day goes on. And the top team in each region gets to attend nationals, which this year was held in Washington, D.C., and it's always held in Washington, D.C. So the Bangor High School team successfully won the state championship, and just last weekend was at, myself included, was at Washington, D.C. to compete. So that was a great experience, a lot of fun.